Okay, good evening everybody. So what is the basic topic which we are going to do today? Any topic of grammar we do, but the thing is that the base should be clear to everyone. When we say about human body, you know, we all are humans. So what are the work of different body parts? You know, what is the work of arms, what is the work of eyes, ears, everything is different. Similarly, we are having language, that is the basic. What is speech? Speech is language. So when we are talking about speech, we should know what are the different parts of speech. Unless we know about all parts of speech, any grammatical term is not clear to us. So first thing is that we should know about all these parts of speech. It is just like human body parts. If you want that the smooth working of the body should go, your all body organs should work properly. Similarly, you should know about the speech, different parts of speech. So I will just take parts of speech. There are 8 parts of speech. So how they are connected to our grammar and how these parts of speech are used. So first is the basic one, which you are doing it from your junior classes. Now, I'll just have a brief introduction, because if we will go in explanatory form, it will be different. So I'm just taking noun. Noun, as you all know, the name of a person, place, animal or a thing. Okay, so noun, just like there's a different forms of noun, common noun, proper noun, abstract noun, material noun, concrete. So these all are different one, collective one. So explanation we will have in a different way, but I'm just recapitulating the things which you already know. Second one is about pronoun. Now what exactly is the meaning of pronoun? If you will break up the word into different parts, noun and pro, it means the replacement of noun. Instead of repeating the name again and again, we will use pronoun in that place. Suppose if I say that Ram is going to attend the birthday party, Ram is going to take the gift. So if again and again I will keep on repeating the name, that will be monotonous. So here I would have to use pronoun, that means the replacement of noun. And what are the replacement? You know that first, second, third person, he, she, it, we, they. So these are the different pronouns which are used instead in the place of noun, so that the repetition should not be there. Okay, so we will come to the third one, which is the basic. You know, whenever we are writing a sentence, it comprising of subject, object plus verb. If verb is not there, so subject and object are useless. So a sentence comprises of subject, object and verb. So verb is basically action word. The main requirement of a sentence is verb. So basically we know about verb, all action words are known as verb. You know about it, you have done it. We also know about what are transitive and intransitive verbs. I'll just give example, transitive verb. Suppose if I say, he sleeps, okay, he sleeps, and the another one is, he sleeps on the bed. So how will you differentiate which verb is transitive, which is intransitive? So here, the subject, the action of the subject stops here. It means the action is not passing. It is intransitive. Okay, the action of the verb is not passing to the object. But when action of the verb is passed to the object, he sleeps on the bed. This is transitive. In the word itself, you will find the meaning. So transitive and intransitive verb we are doing from the beginning. Just only we are having the recap, because in details when we will take noun, pronoun, verb, all the concept, then in detail we will do. Coming to the next one, fourth one. You see, there is another part of speech which is known as adverb. Children, you know in the word itself the meaning is there. So if I say adverb, what it means? It means add plus verb. means adverb is the word which add to the meaning of verb, which qualify the verb. Okay, just like he writes neatly. Now, first of all, we have to find out which is the verb. Here it is the verb. How he writes neatly. It is telling about the verb basically, that how he writes. This is adverb. It adds to the meaning of the verb. Similarly, there is related parts of speech that is known as adjective. Now, what is adjective? Adjective does the same work as adverb does. But what is the basic difference here? Adjective adds to the meaning of noun. You see the difference, very, very clear noun is there. Adjective define noun. Simple thing. If I say he sings sweet song. Okay? He sings sweet song. But if I say he sings sweetly. Okay. Now, how would you define, how would you find out that this is adjective, this is adverb? Word which add to the meaning of verbs is adverb. The word which add to the meaning of noun is adjective. Adjectives are the words which qualify the noun, and adverbs are the words which qualify verb. So both are doing the same duty. One is defining verb, another is defining adjective. So adjective and adverb are having similar work to do. They add to other things, means their presence adds to the importance of other figures or parts of speech. Okay, now five we have done. We have done noun, pronoun, verb, adverb and adjective. Now moving to the sixth one, that is very important one which you are doing in your classes, and you see the meaning itself is clear in the word. Preposition. You see, you break up this position, preposition. Preposition of something. If I say that the duster I hold in my hand, I am going to keep it on the floor. So where I am going to keep it there? On the floor. So what will be the position of the duster? On. So position, preposition, and they are added before that, just like in, on, off, after, before, beside, among. You see that these are simple words which are telling about the position of an object, where it is kept. So like I'm standing below the fan. So here the differences are there which are telling the words, and commonly we are doing in our classes. We know that how we are using it. Okay. That also we will do in detail. Then coming to the next part of speech, that is conjunction. What is conjunction? That is connected word. Okay, connected word. The word which are used for connecting the things. Okay, he came and he took his book and went out. So which are the words they are joining? They are joining two sentences. Those are conjunction. Suppose we are given, or you are given two sentences, and you have to join those sentences. The boy who has taken my book is standing there. So what I am talking about? I am talking about the boy. And which is the word which is joining who? Conjunctions are the word which join a sentence, which join two different sentences or two different words. Conjunctions. Last one which we are doing is interjection. Interjections are the words which are used to express the sudden surprise feeling. How? Sudden surprise feeling means, you know, when you are showing your expression, and those expressions can be of sorrow, they can be of happiness, they can be of surprise also. Suppose if I'm saying, wow. Okay, when I say, wow, I won the lottery. What it exactly is, this is my happiness. Okay, suppose if I lost something, I say, alas, I lost my wallet. So if I say this thing, wow, we won the match. But one thing is there, that will be, there's a difference between exclamatory sentences and interjection. Suppose if I say, there we have to put the sign, wow, then the connected sentence, we won the game. Okay, sign of word which is showing interjection. This is just to show the sudden surprise feeling. Now, in this particular session, I am not going to explain all the terms because that we will take bit by bit. That is the base of everything. If we are not knowing about the basics of something, the things will not be clear to us. So when we are talking about grammar, the first thing which we have to keep in mind are the parts of speech, how they are connected to the language, how they beautify the language, how they ornament the language and give it a proper meaning. So for today, we'll just have the recap. We have done different parts of speech. That is the language. First is a noun, then coming to pronoun, then verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction, interjection. So these we have just done and you already are knowing about it. It is just a recap. And tomorrow we will start about the basic, that is noun. What exactly is noun and what are the different kinds of noun and how it is used. So till the time you just have the revision, and if anything is not clear, then we can take it tomorrow also. Thank you so much.